Hey VC, how's it going? I'm back for my haul video. So this is stuff I've all bought from the last week, last weekend, and then yesterday, Monday. So here is all the stuff I have to show you guys. And I also have a music related book that I bought as well. So I'm not gonna waste any time. I'll just jump into it right here. So one of my old friends introduced me to some old country stuff. I'm pretty grateful for that because I'm not well versed in country at all. I don't like new country. I like some older country stuff. And this first one I found, Garen, I went to Canesville Records on Saturday or Sunday, I don't remember. But I picked up some good stuff there, so thank you for reminding me about that place. This first one is the original Carter Family, My Old Cottage Home. This is a really cool find. This is only $3. It's like a compilation album of their stuff. Johnny Cash actually wrote some notes on the back of here, signed by Johnny Cash. And it just says, selection of Carter Family material that is truly a collector's item. The songs span the entire career of the original Carters and ring with beauty and simplicity, the kind of beauty and simplicity that abound in the country and the people described by Johnny Cash. And this is really good. I really enjoy this. If you like old country, I mean, they're one of the first, I guess, well-known country vocal groups. So this, I'm super happy to have this. All right, next in the same vein, we're going to some old country, not super old, but this is the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, Will the Circle Be Unbroken? You guys, there are so many great country artists that are featured in this. This is a highly praised album. Came out in 1972, I believe. It doesn't say on the back here. But you got Mother Maybelle Carter from the Carter Family, Earl Scruggs, Doc Watson, Merle Travis. There's 37 songs on this, so there's three records. These are all in great shape. It's a gatefold, several cool pictures. Sorry, I know I film in the sun and sometimes just there's that glare. But I bought it mainly for the title track. I've heard that several times. My friend bought this on CD last year and used to listen to it in the car and I really enjoyed it. So I'm super happy to find this on vinyl. It was only $7 and like I said, there's three records in here. This is essential if you like bluegrass and country, just some terrific playing on here. All right, I don't need to say much about this next one. This is the Monkees, their first one. And this is the 1986 Rhino Records release. So this is actually in really good shape. I bought it for $5. Monkees, what can I say? Last Train to Clarksville, that's definitely my favorite song on here and a big hit. Gonna Buy Me a Dog always makes me laugh. Love the Monkees. Next, I bought a Mama Cass Greatest Hits, Mama's Big Ones. I see this at a lot of places, but this one was in great shape, so I picked it up for $5. Someone else in the VC gave me a list of recommended Mama Cass albums to check out. I've been looking for them. I wrote them down. I just haven't seen any in the stores. So, picked this up on vinyl. Alright, next I have some new albums that I bought. I had a Amazon gift card from Christmas, so I decided to use it and buy a few. Now, this first one has already been mentioned by Mark over at Back to the Vinyl, but I thought I would just give it a shout out as well. It's Charly Bliss. I think it's their first album, right? It's called Guppy. They're pretty young. It's a brother and sister in this band. And yeah, it's just like an alternative band. I would call it bubblegum alternative, if that makes sense. Kind of similar to Veruca Salt and their influences, but I'm not gonna do any Needledrops because Mark already has them up on his video. I'll put a link down below to his video where you can check them out if you want some Needledrops. But yeah, just a cute record. Got the lyrics in here. Charly Bliss's Guppy. All right, next is a band. They're a shoegaze band. They're called Cheetahs. Oops. And really cool because they included a CD with the record. I really like that. So yeah, this is a shoegaze band. This came out in 2014, so they're fairly, they're a new band. Nothing original or groundbreaking, but if you like shoegaze and new shoegaze, definitely check this out. This is their debut album, just called Cheetahs. And I'll include some Needledrops here in a second. I like the colors on the gatefold here. But yeah, I'm a big shoegaze fan. I like My Bloody Valentine, Swerve Driver, Ride, all the 90s stuff. So, and they were playing this record in Jurassic Plastic downtown, a record store, and I really just wanted to pick it up. So, but I bought it off Amazon because I had a gift card. So this is Cheetahs, and I'll play you some of their clips right now. You guys know, or you probably know, I'm a huge Juliana Hatfield fan, and so I went on Discogs and I found this release. This is the Blake Babies, the Earwig demos from 1988. So I think this was only available for a short time. It's actually on orange vinyl, very nice. And yeah, the Blake Babies are one of my favorite bands. I would consider myself a completist with their stuff. I have all their singles and all their albums on CD already, but I think this was only released on vinyl. Just good stuff, good jangle pop from the 80s, early 90s. I will go ahead and do some Needledrops for you right now. Blake Babies.
Thank you.
All right, the next album, you guys know I like the raspberries a lot, probably from one of my earlier videos. But this is a solo record from Eric Carmen. He was the singer and songwriter of the Raspberries. This is his second solo album called Boats Against the Current. This is the only album I didn't open up and actually look at in the store, and now I'm paying for it because the second side is totally ruined and scratched up. So I was only able to listen to the first side. There's some great songs on here, at least from the first side. Nowhere to Hide is a beautiful piano track. Take It or Leave It kind of rocks, kind of in the same vein as the Raspberries. But hopefully I can get a better copy in the future. Very disappointed. This is a gatefold though. It's got the lyrics inside. And this is $5, and honestly, seriously, it's ruined. And that corner's torn off or ripped off. So yeah, I was kind of stupid and didn't look at the condition of the record in the store, but I was kind of in a hurry. Still, it should have been like 50 cents condition. This is a guilty pleasure. Go easy on me, you guys. Christopher Cross. When I lived in Arizona for a couple months last year, I did Bikram yoga, which is hot yoga, and it was a class where they played music. So it wasn't, I guess, the standard Bikram class, but they would play mix CDs, and Ride Like the Wind was on there. I had only heard that song a few times before, but after doing the yoga, I just fell in love with that song. So of course I had to get this, and also Sailing is on here. Another cheesy one. So this is a guilty pleasure record right here. Okay, the next one, sort of a blind buy, I guess. I had heard of Maria McKee before. I had heard some of her solo stuff. She's a great singer, great songwriter. This is her first band, Lone Justice. Got this for $3. And when did this come out? 85. And this is their first release. So it's like a country slash pop record. Really good, really good songs on here. Ways to Be Wicked, Sweet Sweet Baby I'm Fallen. Just, she has a really good voice, so I'm happy to have this. Yeah, we're getting into some good 80s finds right now, you guys. All right, the next one is an 80s band from Athens, Georgia. So immediately, you know they're probably gonna be good, right? Because REM hailed from Athens, as did Pylon, and so many other great 80s groups. But this one was another blind buy, okay? And this is a band called Dreams So Real. And this one's their Rough Night in Jericho album. I think it's their second album. This is a promo copy, so there's a big sticker on here. It lists their influences, and on the back there's like a label on the back just saying loan for promotion, not for sale. So this band, on the front here, apparently Peter Buck from REM produced their first single and their first album called Father's House. And this is their second album. I really like this. They are kind of similar to REM. They are kind of in that jangle pop, or probably were played on college radio pretty heavily back in the late 80s. This is from 88. And this one surprised me. I am a new fan of this band. We'll probably be looking for their first album too. I think they only had 3 albums. So, but yeah, it's kind of jangle pop. It's kind of, you got some psychedelic influences here and there. So Dreams So Real, Rough Night in Jericho, that's a great find. I'm gonna play you some Needledrops here.
Thank you.
super excited to find this EP. I love the Waitresses, and this is their EP. It's called I Could Rule the World If I Could Only Get the Parts. I have never seen this anywhere, ever. I haven't seen any Waitresses records so far, so I was just thrilled to find this. It was $7. It's in wonderful shape. I've already played it, cleaned it. It's wonderful. And you'll recognize the song Christmas Wrapping, probably. That was a big hit. So that's on side one. Also, Square Pegs, that's on side two. Just super happy to have this, you guys. Patty Donahue, she was pretty awesome. This band was new wave-ish, post-punk. I've got, the only thing I have from them is a greatest hits on CD. So it's pretty nice to have this EP now. I think the singer died in the 90s from cancer or something, maybe lung cancer, which is pretty sad. I think she may have been in her 40s, so pretty young. Okay, next is a band I'm not too familiar with. I've heard just their singles, I guess. And this is Squeeze's East Side Story. This is what, their fourth album. This is so good, you guys. I'm gonna be looking for more Squeeze albums. This is only $4 and it's in excellent condition. So apparently Elvis Costello produced this album, or he was one of the producers. He also sang a part on Tempted. You guys know the song Tempted, that's on this one. Ooh, this is so good. I'm excited to have this. I don't really know what else to say about it. It's a brilliant album. All right, we're getting into some old stuff now. I'm a big Judy Garland fan. So this compilation is just called Forever Judy. And what do we got on here? Over the Rainbow, the Trolley song. I love that. And Singing in the Rain is on here. But what's awesome about this, and I bought this for $6.99, it's in really good condition. I mean, of course, you're going to have some crackles and pops just because these are really old recordings. But there was a poster in there. Check this out. This is super old. Can you see that? Forever Judy? Awesome. So that was a little bonus. When I didn't see that in the store. I saw the poster when I got home. So, very nice. Alright, next, I bought two more Frank Sinatra albums, you guys. I am in a huge Frank Sinatra phase, I guess. So forgive me if you're bored with me showing Frank Sinatra stuff, but I've got two more, all right? The first one is Strangers in the Night. This is my favorite one so far. Lisa at Groovy Lisa actually said this is her favorite too. Thank you for giving me a heads up on that, because yeah, this is just a stunning album. Wow. Especially side one. Strangers in the Night, All or Nothing at All, Call Me, You're Driving Me Crazy. Wow. Frank at one of his best periods right here. All right, someone else kind of said this was their favorite Frank album. I don't remember who on the VC said this. Sorry, I should have took some notes. But I remembered this album that they mentioned, and it's September of My Years. I don't know, like, what order these came out. I don't know what number album this was for him. I found that you have to be in a mood to listen to this album, because it's, you know, very contemplative, nostalgic, looking back on his life. So it kind of depressed me in a way, especially the first side here. But yeah, still good Frank stuff. Along the same lines, I'll just show you the book I bought. It's a Frank book, and Frank Sinatra, My Father, written by his daughter Nancy Sinatra. So I picked this up for $2. I figure, why not? I'm in a big Frank phase, so I'll read a little about him too. Okay, we're down to the last one, you guys. Again, I want to say that these were in no particular order of preference or anything. So I was kind of surprised to see this, because I've never seen it on vinyl anywhere. And I picked up Madonna's True Blue. This is her third album and released in 1986. I bought this album because, and I'm not a huge Madonna fan, I'll start off by saying, but Live to Tell is on here, and that's my favorite Madonna song ever. But this one has so many hits. Papa Don't Preach, Open Your Heart, True Blue, Live to Tell. Oh, so good. Perfect condition. I actually paid $16.99 for this. I don't know if that's good or bad. But I noticed that it came with a poster here. Pretty cool. I guess maybe, yeah. So, perfect condition. Kind of nice to have a Madonna album, I guess. I love her early stuff, so if I do happen to run across her first two albums as well, I'll probably pick them up. But I'm not like a huge Madonna fan by any means. So, I'll just put that away later. It takes me a while for the sleeves. So, yeah. How'd you guys like that haul? I was pretty happy with those finds myself. I'm probably gonna have to take a little bit of a break in the next week or two. Probably in the next month, I will be inheriting a lot of albums, a lot of older albums. So I have that to look forward to. I just don't know exactly when that's gonna happen. And there's a record show coming to Omaha on March 25th. So I'll definitely be checking that out as well. All right, if you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up. Of course, I'm looking for more subscribers, even though I have like 220 right now. How the heck did that happen? I'm ecstatic about that, you guys. That's awesome. Thank you so much for watching. Apparently, I must be doing something right. You guys have a great week, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.